Okay, we're going to write sine of 3x in terms of sine of 1x only. So, to do so, we have to make sure let's look at 3x as something plus something. We can do it as 2x plus x, that will give us 3x, okay? Or you can also do it as plus 2x, up to you. Well, I will show you guys this as sine of 2x plus x. And the reason I want to do that is because, you see, now I have the sum of two things, first and the second, right? And we can use the angle sum formula for the sine, which it says this is going to be sine of the first right here, which is 2x, and then we multiply by cosine of the second, which is x, like this. And then we will be adding this with sine of the second, which is the x right here, and we multiply this with cosine of the first. And this is the angle sum formula for the sine. Well, if you look at this right here, we have sine of 2x, and that's the double angle situation for the sine, right? And we have the double angle formula for that as well. So for this, I will write that as 2 sine x times cosine x. This right here is just the double angle formula for the sine. And then for the cosine x, I will just keep it as how it is, because, well, there's nothing that I can do at the moment. And notice that I didn't use the parentheses right here anymore, because for all the x right here, just one thing inside of the sine or cosine. Earlier, I used the parentheses just to make sure I want to make everything super clear, right? Because of the two things inside of the sine. Okay, we'll continue. This is plus the sine x. I cannot do anything, so I will just keep it as how it is. But once again, I see the cosine of 2x, isn't it? That's a double angle for the cosine, and we also have a formula for that. Well, we have a total of three versions for the cosine of 2x. Which one should we use? Keep in mind, our goal is to write sine of 3x in terms of sine of 1x only. So the first thing I want to use right here is 1 minus 2 sine squared x. I don't want to see any more cosine whenever possible, right? So I just want to replace cosine of 2x with this version of that formula. Yes, I still have the cosine right here, but you'll see how we can do it later on. All right, to continue, we see that this is the 2 sine x, and then cosine x times cosine x, this is cosine squared x. And then right here, we have the sine x in front of this parentheses, so let's go ahead, distribute, right? Sine x times 1 is just plus sine x, and then sine x times negative 2 sine squared x, it will be negative 2 sine x, and sine x squared, it's sine to the third power x, like this. Okay, what can we do next? We did a lot of work already, but you have to follow direction. We don't want to see any cosine. This is sine x, this is sine x, this is technically sine x, and then to a third power, so this is also good. This is no good. But if you look at this right here, cosine squared x, we can write as 1 minus sine squared x, isn't it? So we'll replace this right here, right? So I will show you as this. This is 2 times sine x, and this is 1 minus sine squared x. And then this right here stays the same because these are good terms, right? Plus sine x, and then minus 2 sine to a third power x. For this right here, once again, we distribute, and then we will get 2 sine x times 1, that's 2 sine x. And then this times that, we will have minus 2. Sine x times sine to the second power x, it will be sine to the third power x. And this is plus sine x, and then we still have this, minus 2 sine to the third power x. And now, what can we do next? Well, we can combine like terms, because I noticed that this right here is 2 sine x. And then we are adding one more sine x right here. Together, they will be 3 sine x. And right here, I'm just adding the terms. So the sine x stays the same. I'm just doing 2 plus 1. Combine like terms, we get the 3 and then the sine x, right? Likewise, I see that I have minus 2 sine to a third power x, and this is minus 2 sine to a third power x. minus 2 minus 2 is minus 4, right? So we can have minus 4, and then the term stays the same, which is the sine to the third power x, like that. Once again, you see, we have the sine x here, and this is technically sine x in the parentheses and then to a third power. We wrote sine of 3x in terms of sine x already, and this is the identity, okay, for sine of 3x, and that's it.